السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome to our next session on Asma al-Husna. Now we are reaching the last 10 days of Shahr Ramadan. There's about a week to go now. And I want to ask you, have you felt a little bit more connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Hopefully your answer is yes. Because when we get to know more about someone and their amazing qualities, it allows us to get connected to them, to feel closer to them, and to love them even more because of the love that they show to us. So today's beautiful name that we're going to be looking at is one that will definitely make you smile. Today's ism is Al-Wali. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our friend, and not just any old friend, but a protective friend, a friend that showers us with love and care and gives us so much without us even asking. He never gives up on us, but it is our job to be able to get close to him. A friend can only become our friend when we let them. So the question is, how ready am I to let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala become my friend? And not just any old friend, but my BFF, my best friend forever. So I want you to think of your own friends. What friends do you like spending time with? Is it the ones that make you sad? Is it the ones that make you unhappy and glum? Or is it the ones that are always smiling? The ones that you love spending time with, are they the ones that bring you joy? Are they the ones that are there in your difficult times? I'm sure those are the friends that you enjoy and you love spending the most time with them. So if we want to make sure that we have good friends, I need to make sure that I'm being a good friend in the first place. Looking for friends is important, but also being that good friend is so important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we should be friends that help other people become better. I should be a friend that helps my friends to become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I should be a friend that teaches other people to do good things, to help those in need, to look for little ways in doing good deeds. If I'm a friend like this, then these are the kind of friends that I will attract. It's really, really important that when I'm trying to be a good friend, I also look for friends that will help me to become better. It's so important to choose our friends wisely. Do you know why? Because without us even realizing, they rub off on us. Whatever friends that we are around, their qualities and their traits will rub off on us. Let me explain to you. If I had a friend who was kind, who was smiling, and who was loving, and if I just walked past them and I brushed past them, even without doing anything, they will rub off on me. I'm sure you can see the black that's on my hand. But if I had a friend who was rude, who was always fighting, and who was mean, even if I brushed past them, they would still rub off on me too. So whatever kind of friends I have, they will always rub off on me. So I need to make sure, if I want to be a good, loving, kind, and caring person, my friends should have these qualities too. Let me give you another example. Have any of you been into a perfume shop before? Even if you haven't bought a perfume and you've just walked through the shop and come out the other end, you will still have that scent of perfume on you. You didn't buy the perfume, but just by being in there, the smell rubbed off on you. In the same way, our friends are so important because their good qualities and sometimes their not so good qualities also rub off on us. But by looking for these friends, I need to ensure to myself, what kind of friend am I being? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Wali and is my protective friend, am I being a good enough friend for Him to then be able to be a good enough friend for others? So our question today is, how do I adopt the quality of Al-Wali into my life? First of all, I need to be able to count Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as not just my Rabb, not just my Creator, but my BFF, my best friend forever. And what do we do with our BFF? We turn to them in times of need. We talk to them for hours, not just having to be on the musalla. We speak to them about everything. We want to share everything with them. I want us to try and have this bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that He is our best friend, that will not give His back on us, that will not turn away from us, but will always shower us with love, whether we deserve it or not. Secondly, I want us to be careful of the friends that we choose. Always look for friends that will allow us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look for friends that take us closer to our full potential, that motivate us, that encourage us, and that make us feel good. These are the type of friends we need to try and have. And thirdly, I need to try and become that good friend. If I want to be able to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I need to be able to take my friends on that journey with me. So I hope today's name has made you smile. It definitely has made me smile, because it made me realize that even if I have no one around me, my BFF will always be there with me. Join me again tomorrow to learn a new name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same time, same place. Assalamu alaikum.